Hey guys, it's Kat, and as you can tell by my silver outfit today, we're gonna do one of the scariest makeup transformations of It. The movie industry decided to relaunch Stephen King's movie It when Tim Curry played It, and I have such high hopes for this. I hope it goes well. I'm a huge fan of this creepy clown. Warning, this video is super creepy and probably one of the most scariest things I've ever done because it is of a clown, of course. I'm warning you now, this is the only time. And I am so excited about this because most kids grew up on Disney Channel and Nickelodeon, and I grew up on Stephen King's It, the movie Rose Red, and the TV show X-Files. So things like this are right up my alley, and I hope this movie does not disappoint. The original Pennywise had bright red hair that was obviously fake with a big fake nose. This version, he reminds me of the villain from A Christmas Story, and he has more natural ginger hair, and he has different type of face paint, with red marks coming from his mouth, near his eyes, and it's creepy, but really realistic to where he almost looks more human than clown. But we will see how the new version turns out, and let's get on with the makeup transformation. To start off with the most creepiest clown makeups ever, I'm gonna put my hair in a low ponytail, or I'm doing a braid because I'm gonna put on a bald cap. Once you get your low ponytail or braid situated, I'm gonna put some clips in my hair just to get my bangs and the little baby hairs out of the way because I have so many baby hairs and that is totally not fun for putting on a bald cap. And I'm gonna clean the area around my forehead where the bald cap's gonna adhere to my skin. You even wanna do it behind your ears and clean that area as well. Then I'm getting a bald cap. I have never used this brand of bald cap before. It almost looks like one of those swimmer caps like in the Olympics that swimmers wear, but skin tone, which is kind of creepy. And I'm gonna get some very tiny scissors to cut away holes for my ears. This is very hard. You do not want to cut your ear off. If you've never done a bald cap, you could totally skip this step and just do the straight makeup with a wig. But I really want to be realistic, and Pennywise the clown, his hairline's always back way far. And this new clown has a very large head as well, with a receding hairline. So you just wanna cut back the bald cap on both sides of your head to fit your head properly, to glue it down around your ears. I'm just getting some hairspray in between fitting this bald cap to slick down those baby hairs a little more because, like I said, I have a lot of them. Putting that bald cap on to cut the other side of it to fit around my ear. Honestly, bald caps are so difficult. Whenever I put one on, it reminds me of the old movie called The Coneheads. Has anyone else seen that? Maybe I'm just old. But once you cut away the fake flesh from your fake bald head cap thing, that looks like a glove sleeve for your head, we're gonna get some adhesive. I am using Telesis today, which is very expensive, but you could also use Prozade. And I'm putting that around my hairline, not on my hair. Do not put this on your hair, but on your skin where the bald cap is going to adhere to it to make it hopefully look like a realistic bald head. Like I said, please don't get this in your hair. It's not fun. And I'm trying to adhere it to the sides of my neck and it won't go all the way down because I will tuck it into my costume later. I had such difficulty with this bald cap because, like I said before, I've never used this brand before and I was so afraid of it tearing on me. It was the only bald cap I had left. And once that bald cap adhesive is drying, we're gonna glue down our eyebrows with some Elmer's glue stick and then powder it just as a first layer before getting some liquid latex. No, this is not for our eyebrows. This is for the edge of the bald cap to make it seem like there's no seam going into your natural skin texture. I got a red stipple sponge, which is the perfect type of density to make little stipple marks of skin texture. You don't have to do it all around the bald cap for this makeup look, but usually you have to because that's where it's gonna be shown on camera with the wig that we're gonna put on later, and we're gonna put on a collar of the clown outfit. And while that liquid latex is drying, we are gonna do another layer of glue stick for our brows with some powder. You could do 2 to 3 or 4 or how many ever layers of glue stick and powder as long as they dry completely between each layer, to flatten them down so that we could paint on them. So it'll make it look like our human has no eyebrows because it's not really human. It's a soulless clown. That's very scary. Drying that down with a blow dryer, as you can see, because this really helps. Like I said, you need every layer to be dry on the eyebrows. Now I'm getting a Ben Nye cream paint in white, and I'm going to paint that on top of my eyebrows and around my eyes. All the areas where it would usually crease that has more thin layers of skin, like on your eyelids, on your bottom lid, around the crevices of your nose, on top of your nose, but I made a little mistake. I put too much white cream paint there, so I'm getting a makeup remover wipe to wipe off the tip of my nose. That sounds really creepy, but because we're gonna put a red nose there later, and I'm gonna powder down this whole entire area of my face that I put white makeup on. Now, I'm gonna get some white aqua paint. I'm using Wolf Brothers for this because it has a waxy consistency compared to Graftopia, which is more water-based, because it has a more opaque coloring to it, so it'll hide the shadow of my hair on this bald cap. If you're doing a full face of white makeup, it could be difficult. You want to work fast. And I switch between a damp beauty sponge that isn't a beauty blender because those are really expensive and you do not want to ruin them. This is by Ofra. And then I switch over to a foundation brush or a paint brush to do another layer on top of that while it's still wet and damp. This will give the best coverage and make that white really opaque and pigmented. You want to make sure you really cover the top of your forehead. You don't have to cover all the way to the back of your forehead because that's where we're gonna put the wig. And please do not forget to paint your ears. Once you have all of your forehead and face, and you even want to paint on your neck down to your costume completely white, looking like we just dunked our head into a tub of Oreo cream filling. That sounds delicious. And we're gonna use a hairdryer to dry all this before powdering it down with translucent powder. Now, to paint on them brows. This version of Stephen King's It of Pennywise has very prominent eyebrows. They're not drawn on necessarily. They're like shadows that are swirly marks. That's as best as I can explain them. So I'm getting a matte black eyeshadow to lightly dust on the design of his eyebrows. It's gonna start a little bit on top of my natural brow where it was, and then go into a very high arch and swirl towards the middle of my forehead, above the bridge of my nose. The reason why you wanna use eyeshadows for this, because it's more forgiving if you make a mistake. And I'm doing some shadow marks under dark circles where they would be on my eyes, and a little bit on my frown marks above the brows. I'm also getting this matte black eyeshadow, very pigmented with a pencil brush. You can even use a little bit of eyedroppers in your eyeshadow to make it very pigmented, to do a liner that's very thick and dramatic. And then move on to a lighter, almost gray, but still black eyeshadow with another pencil brush and blend that into the white. So it's gonna fade into the white a little bit without doing a complete smoky eye. You want to look like that little boy from The Grudge who's really scary, who like has his mouth open and haunts people and sounds like a cat sometimes. Now I'm getting a black eyeliner pencil to color in my waterline. Before getting more cream paint, I'm gonna mix black and red cream paint to make like a blood red instead of a bright tone red to color in my nose. You don't wanna color your whole entire nose, just the tip of it and down by your nostrils, but not below your nostrils. You don't want to bring this down on your upper lip, just where the bulbous original clown nose would be. I think a lot of people that do this makeup, they don't realize that the red of the nose and his mouth is more of a blood red than a bright red, in my opinion. So I'm also gonna take the same cream paint with the lip brush and color in like the lipstick of his lips. You just wanna follow the natural lip line of your mouth. And once you're done with that, we're gonna start doing the design on his cheeks that go up near the bottom of his lash line. Apart from the bald cap, like I said, you don't have to do that. This part is probably the most difficult of the whole makeup design, because you have to get both sides of your face semi-even, the design of the curling red mark. And once you have it semi-even on both sides, we're gonna make designs of the dash marks of the red paint on our eyebrows, going up to our forehead. You definitely want to look at pictures of the new Pennywise the Clown from the newest It movie to succeed a little bit at this makeup, because I'm trying to study as much detail as I can. It's kind of sad drawing these red dashes through our magnificent swirly eyebrows, but it has to happen. Now I'm gonna get some matte black eyeshadow again with a big stipple brush and do some shadow around my forehead and the sides of my face. This Pennywise the Clown has more of a decaying effect, so I'm also gonna do some drip marks of black alcohol paint, or you can use watered down cream paint. And once that is all done, we are gonna put in some teeth. Off camera, I put in these fangs, which is really difficult to put in. And then I'm gonna put on Pennywise the Clown's silver collar. As I'm putting this on, you can see this was the original Pennywise the Clown outfit that I had, and I just painted it silver from like the waist up, and I didn't really paint the arms. I probably should. If I was cosplaying this and really serious, I would have painted the whole outfit, but I was running out of paint. And we're gonna get a red ginger wig. This is a crazy looking wig that, as you can see, I cut down the middle to have widow's peak, and it really set far back on his hairline to make his head look large. You really want to style this wig to look just like the movie. I just used some red costume hairspray and cut this wig, which was originally from my Ed Sheeran video, so it's just a ginger male wig. And these fangs were werewolf fangs from the Halloween store that I stocked up on after Halloween was over. Now, Pennywise the Clown, it would not be himself without piercing yellow eyes. We're gonna put some special effect lenses in. And with that, we are completely done with our Pennywise the Clown makeup transformation from the newest It movie reboot. Like I said, I cannot wait to see this. Does anyone else love horror movies? If you do, what's your favorite horror or scary movie? This was definitely one of mine growing up. I'm also a huge fan of Jeepers Creepers. In a wrong turn. I know a lot of people have been saying I've been doing really creepy makeups lately. All my other cute makeups of Frappuccinos and trolls and stuff, you guys say that it's kind of creepy and kind of cute at the same time. Well, this I think tops it all because it is so creepy. But sadly, it's time for me to turn back into a human from this creepy clown. Just looking at this while I was editing, oh my goodness. But if you guys do this makeup or any makeup from my YouTube channel, please post it on Instagram and tag me #catsketch. You can follow me on Patreon and all other social media such as Snapchat down below. I'm on there every day practically. You could stalk me like It, the clown, stalks kids. Creepy? Yes, cat. And I can't wait to do more makeups for you guys this summer. Sweet dreams. Love y'all. Bye.